friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear.
Then to you he has said, to you who for refuge to Jesus has fled. One of the verses that my dad used to really emphasize was the fourth verse of that. When through fiery trials thy pathway shall lie, my grace all sufficient shall be thy supply. The flame shall not hurt thee. I only design thy dross to consume and thy gold to refine. Great, great song.
Singing, but we didn't even hear the the concept of love.
In fact, this guy that wrote the book, this guy that escaped from the camp, he ratted out his own mother and his older brother because they were trying to escape from the camp. And because he ratted them out, they executed his own mother and executed his older brother. And it was just that he grew up in that environment that you, if you wanted to have anything nice done for you or whatnot, you squealed on everybody else, even if it was your own family member. And at the time when he did it, he didn't feel any remorse over it, because even his own mother didn't express love toward him. So, you know, when I hear about the opportunity to sing, you don't understand what a blessing it is to be able to make music and to sing songs of praise and to hear things like love, because that was a scary thing for me about reading that book or listening to it. There's over, I think they said close to it, they estimate 200,000 people in prison camps over there in North Korea. They know nothing about this world that we live in. And it's hard to imagine that that's going on, but it is going on. So I'm grateful that we can sing. I know, keep my mouth shut.
624
Blue Book. 624 Blue Book. I played part of that right before the service this morning. Been a while since we've done it. A good reminder that God's eyes on us.
Jesus is my God.
nice birds. That's nice. That is nice. Anybody else? You don't have to sing one more if you don't want.
Page 169 in the Hymns of Faith book.
Okay. Because He Lives?
Yep.
Yes, sir. 169.
White book.
And you may even remember it. Remembering. You may not even need a book. And you do realize that this song is now over 50 years old. How many of you remember when this song first came out? Bill Gaither. Over 50 years of age. Look at that. Written back in 1971. Church from 2008 to 2014, and during that time period and even after that, he stopped serving only because he just felt like it was getting too difficult to pull his thoughts together for services, and then my mom developed some health problems and whatnot. But they would go up on Sunday nights and Wednesday nights, and they'd be the only two that were there. Back, that was before Betty Trickett joined us, and sometimes Betty Trickett would come, and sometimes J.R. Greer would end up being there. But I'm telling you, it's just wonderful to see folks in the house of the Lord. Thank you. I know the Lord has to get excited too. Whoa, look at there. People are in my house tonight. It's not sitting empty. So thank you for being here. She was just reminding me that next Sunday is a fifth Sunday. You say, what does that mean? Fifth Sunday, we historically at the church, now we haven't done much this year, but fifth Sunday was always just a music night. And we would sing songs for the entire time. So we can do that next Sunday night. We can spend a whole time.
If anybody has any special songs they want to sing, go to front and sing.
And we can really liven things up and make it exciting. We're going to have a sign-up thing at the beginning of the door, give everybody a little piece of paper, put them in a hat, shake them up, pull a name out, and they'll sing a special. You won't want to miss it. You just need to pray it's not your. You just need to pray it's not your name that gets drawn out.
Well, I don't like it drawn. I didn't have no drawing.
Well, Joe, for those of you that weren't here earlier this year, Joe blessed us. He never in his life sung a solo, so we put him on the spot and he did it. And the song that he sang was, "Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. Thank you, Lord, for making me whole." And so, anyhow, I was inspired by it. I don't know about you. No, he did. He did. And I've oftentimes tried to tell people, it's not the beauty. Having a beautiful voice is nice, but it's the meaning behind it. And one of my favorite scenes from The Sound of Music is the old nun that sings there in the abbey. Her voice has long since, it's past its prime, but that woman just sings "Climb Every Mountain," so on and so forth, and it's just absolutely very moving. It's not because so much the quality of the voice, but the expression of the heart, and that's really what is makes music most meaningful. So anyhow, what I was going to tell you, after Joe had done that, better yet, demonstrate, yeah, Joe. Why don't you bless him?
It wasn't bad enough he did it to me once. We're at the men's prayer breakfast at West Liberty. And he did it to me again. But I've done it twice. I've sung solos twice in my life.
Third time's a charm.
No. Yeah. And he's the one who put me in the spot both times.
Yeah, but if you would like to sing a special music, and songs that really mean a lot to you, and songs music is one of those things that moves people. And Mary, I think about you. Mary Conaway passed away. And especially Dolores Johnson, but those two women told me on multiple occasions, what a blessing you were singing.
One time Mary Conaway called me and she was down and she said, "Mary, would you do me a favor?" And I said, "Sure, if I can." She said, "Would you sing me a song?" I sang her a song over the phone. I thought, "What am I going to do, Lord?"
So.
And she said, "You don't know."
Amen. Amen. So music is one of those things that God has given it to us to be a blessing, and we need to enjoy it. So we're going to try to enjoy it. Thank you for reminding me. We'll look forward to it.
Pastor, I keep a songbook in my devotion area, which is my workshop. And I keep a songbook, and I do practice. But I have...
It shows, Joe.
But I used to have part of my devotion, and I don't know if the Lord thinks it's... kind of off-key, which it probably is, but it inspires me to go through the book and sing those songs. They're such an inspiration to me, too. I use them as part of my devotion.
Amen. Well, I've told you before, because I've heard him say it on the Christian radio station, songbook is the second best book of theology that you and I have. A book of theology. Theology, theosology, the study of God. The old hymnals especially, because they try to screen, at least the Southern Baptists do with the hymn books that they do, so that it's theologically accurate. You may end up asking, well, there's some other Christian songs that I enjoy, such as, why don't we ever sing our song books one day at a time? Well, these people that end up putting the book together, especially with the Southern Baptists, they maybe just didn't feel like there was enough theological content in there.
And so they've made an emphasis that really the second best book of theology, and I'm not saying that I disagree with the song One Day at a Time, because I find myself saying it. And there's a lot of truth to it. But I'm just telling you, they really, when they put those songs in there, they agreed to allow them in the songbooks. They don't allow every song in there, because some of them, there's just not, I'll use as another expression, it's another reason why you don't see deep and wide in the songbook. Now, you stopped it. How many of y'all used to sing that as a child, going deep and wide, there's a fountain flowing deep and... So, what's the real theological content there? Well, we spiritualize it and say the fountain, speaking about the blood of Christ. But, you know, it's one of those things that when you've got a songbook, Joe, I applaud that. One of the things about Mary Conaway, and we'll go ahead with the rest of the service, but Mary Conaway used to get me when I would go to visit her and Paul. Paul was in a nursing home over in Steubenville for almost 9 years at Carrie Jen. She would invariably have a songbook with her, and she would be reading during the course of the day those songs. And I usually try to go over once a week, at least once a week, and play for her and Paul. It didn't start out that way. But she would end up reading the words of a song, and she would say to me when I go over there, "Tim, how does this song go?" She says, "I really like the words to it." So it can minister to us, Joe. It absolutely can. And by all means, Joe, you did a magnificent job of singing. Maybe next week we'll get you to sing again. We'll put a big billboard out there next to the road. Appearing Sunday night in concert, the one, the only. Sorry. Enough of my silliness.
You open up the windows.
We'll open the windows so that the community can hear. How about prayer requests? I do have a special prayer request right before I came to the church. And Goldie told me it was okay. Goldie Black back here had called. And Fred and Goldie, their son PJ, died about 12 years ago. And they've also got a daughter, Amanda. And Amanda has been with Zach. I can't even remember what Zach's last name is. He's come to the church before. But he's out of his kind of thinking right now. I don't know if it's chemical imbalance or what. But she said that he's really bad right now. And I tried to encourage her that they need to call in somebody if he's not able to, you know, handle things. And she said, he doesn't want to go. And I said, well, that's where an intervention may be necessary. But she says, I do want you to pray for us, because she's very concerned about him, very concerned about Amanda, very concerned about them. And I says, really, when somebody gets off like that, we've seen too many times in the news, it can be bad for society. So pray for Zach and the family back there. But that's just kind of an immediate need right now. Here's a second thing that I pray, ask that you would keep us in prayer. Not nearly as serious. Some of y'all know that hear about within the past month or so, I saw a piano that was for sale. It was a baby grand piano over near Pittsburgh. And to make a long story short, we're going to get that piano. And my dad had made the suggestion to get it because they were only asking $50 for it. It's an absolutely beautiful piano. And I wanted to get it and give it to the church over there where he goes and where mom went, in memory of my mom and of my younger brother Mike that passed away. And so we're having a little bit of difficulty right now getting the piano mover lined up. So pray for us that we can get piano mover lined up. By the way, the lady that had the piano that was asking only $50 for it, she found out why it was being given and where it was going, and she says, I don't want anything for it. She says, I would just like to donate it. So that's even very, yeah, it's very, very nice. And I've got pictures of the piano. If you want to see pictures of the piano, it's absolutely beautiful. So, like I said, that does not even begin to be on the same level of prayer needs as what Zach is back there. But I just ask that you pray for us that we can get that worked out and get that over there. I'll let you know this too. Today and next Sunday, their pianist that they have over there is not going to be there. And so they asked my dad to fill in this Sunday and next Sunday, right? So my dad's doing that, and people say, oh, that's nice. Pop's 87, or he's going to be 87 here in about a week and a half. And he can't get his fingers and stuff to operate the way they used to. But I just think that it's wonderful that they're going to be getting that over there. So you folks know how I feel about music. All right, what other prayer requests do you have? Anybody have any? She lost her checkbook. She can't find it. Pray for her.
Yeah, that would
absolutely.
That would upset you.
Yeah.
Okay.
There was a name in the paper yesterday. Well, I grew up with Ronnie Davis. He was a little bit younger than I was, but there was three brothers: Jimmy, Bobby, and Ronnie. Bobby, you talk about mixed up. Ronnie and Jimmy have died. Oldest one, Bobby.
So, the Ronnie Davis family?
Davis, Ronnie Davis family.
Okay.
I don't know anything about him. I just saw his name in the paper.
Okay.
And I recognized who he was.
Okay.
We grew up together.
Okay. Well, certainly our prayers are with him. Any others?
My 8-year-old great-granddaughter, she's on restrictions right now. No milk, no cheese, no dairy products right now. For the last year and better, this child has had bowel problems. She gets constipated, then she has loose bowel. So her PD doctor has put her on restrictions right now, so the school is having fix a separate, different lunch for her, and they're having fits over that. But if this don't work, the dairy situation, they're sending her to Morgantown to a specialist for her bowels, and they're hoping it don't come to that, because they say if it does, they'll probably have to do surgery on her bowels.
What's her name?
Eliana.
Eliana. E-L-I-A-N.
Don't ask. They don't spell it the way I do.
Eliana, last name?
Riggs.
Riggs. Okay.
We just call her L-L.
Okay. Any others? Well, let's pray together. Father, we've come to your house tonight. We're grateful we could be here, and I appreciate those that have come, and I pray your blessing upon them. We say thank you for the blessings that you've given us. We thank you very much for the beautiful weather that you send. And again, we're thankful for the freedom that we have to come. We come before you tonight, Father, asking that you would meet everybody's needs, especially these that we've talked about. Father, I do pray for Eliana. Pray that she doesn't have to have anything radical done. That, Father, that you would turn this situation around so that she could end up functioning normally. Please, Father, lay your hand of healing upon her and bless her family. I do thank you that both Craig and Dan are with us tonight, and I do pray for their dad. I pray, Father, that you would help him to be able to get this procedure done, if that's what needs to be done, in order for the bladder to be able to function properly. But then also I pray that he will not, pray that he does not have any sort of stomach cancer. Help him as he continues to battle the effects of Agent Orange. Thank you for your service to our country. But please bless him and bless them as they try to take care of their dad. I do pray, as Chuck has mentioned, for Ron Davis' family, Lord, that you'll comfort them. Don't know the circumstances surrounding his death, but Father, I know that the absence of a loved one really makes a profound effect upon all those around. And I pray, Father, that you might comfort them and meet their needs. I pray for the situation back here with Fred and Goldie and Amanda and Zach, that, Lord, you would please help Zach. I know that they've had to get him into treatments in the past, and I pray, Father, that you might once again help to get him not just straightened out once, but straightened out for good. That, Lord, that he could be freed from all of this stuff and that he could be given a new life. Please, Father, help them. I pray, Father, that you'd help Miss Bessie with finding her checkbook. We ask you, Lord, that you would help her to be able to locate that, and that she could get the peace of mind from that. And I pray about the moving of the piano, that, Father, we're trying to get somebody lined up to get the piano moved. We just pray that it could get moved this week. But we come before you because you told us to bring all of our names to you. We rejoice with Mary Collins. Makisha had two beautiful babies this past week, and we pray your blessing upon them. And I know that we still have Brianna Pope on our list because she needs prayer for having a baby. But Lord, meet their needs. And then I'm going to mention one more. We didn't talk about it, but Sheila's sitting over here because she's always quiet. On the 27th, she has to go and have this procedure done to try to break up these kidney stones. And we just pray, Father, that it'll be successful this time and that she won't have to have the stent any longer. But you've told us to bring our requests to you, and we bring them to you, Father, and we ask that you would please have mercy and meet our needs. Thank you for being our God. We love you. We pray that our lives will always reflect it. Just continue to keep us in your care. Guide us, Lord, that we'll do your will. Help, Father, us to turn back to you as a nation. Send revival to your people. Convict those that are lost that they need to get saved. And, Father, help us to get turned back to you. In Jesus' name we pray.